Good day to all of you. I expect that you have learnt Impress 1, the first module of Impress, properly and have understood it. Impress 1 ends here. In the next class, you will appear for a practical test. And after that, you will give a written test conducted by Computer Shiksha. In today's class, you will revise some options from amongst the options that you have learnt in Impress 1. Can you tell which toolbar you will use to format any object? To format any object, we will use line and filling toolbar. Can you tell what needs to be done to change a title slide to a blank slide? To change a title slide into a blank slide, first you need to go to slide layout and select blank slide, and your slide will change into a blank slide. Can you tell in how many ways you can insert a new slide? You can insert a new slide by two methods. First, you can go to slide pane and do right click and select new slide option. This will insert a new slide. Second, you can click on insert menu and select new slide option. This will insert a new slide. Can you tell what happens with header and footer? With header and footer options, you can insert the date and time, any heading, a title, or the slide number in the bottom of the slide. Why do we use bullets and numbering? The option for bullets and numbering is used for making lists. You can insert numbers or any symbols in front of the lines. Why do we use slide design? With the use of slide design, you can change the design of the slide. What happens with uppercase? With uppercase, you can change all letters of a paragraph into capital letters. Now, all of you switch on your computer and open the Impress file. Have you been able to open the file or not? Come. Let us now know what we will be revising in today's class. Today, you will all make a PDF file. Then, you will use the duplicates option to create a duplicate copy of an image. Then, you will show how you will use the header and footer and show how you can change the design of the slide. You will also use custom animation option. In the end, you will show how a hyperlink is inserted and will revise all these options. Let us now begin today's class. First, show how you will insert four slides. Each slide should have a different design. In the first slide, choose the title slide from the layout and type out the paragraph about Computer Shiksha being shown to you. Next, on one line, apply bold italic and show font color formatting. If you face a problem, watch the video and take its help to do this. With this video, let us now practice the use of bold, italic, and font color options. So, to apply the font changes, we need to first select the line. So, select the line as is being shown to you in the video. Then, take the pointer to the formatting bar, the B option. You can also use Ctrl plus B as the shortcut command. Once you press on the B option, you will notice that the line that you had selected becomes bold. Next, Let's select the next line and change these fonts into italics. To do that, bring your pointer to the I option and click on it. And you will notice that it changes to italics. The shortcut command for doing this is Control plus I. Let's once again select the entire paragraph and then take our pointer to the A option, which is for helping us change the font color. Click on the drop-down button and you see many colors are available. Select the color that you like. And once you select that, you can see that that color gets applied to the font of your selected text. So this is how we can change to bold italics and change the font color. Take the next blank slide and draw a picture of the earth and write some lines about it. If you have a doubt, then watch the video and do this with the video's help. We will now insert a new slide and insert in it the Earth's picture from gallery and write a few lines about it. So to first get a new slide, bring your pointer to the slide pane, right click on it and click on the new slide. So now you have a title slide which is new, but we want a blank layout. So click on the blank layout to make this blank. Now to insert a picture here from gallery, we need to take our pointer to the tools option, left click on it and then click on gallery. So the gallery opens and you can see that there are many themes. The first one, arrows, is opened here, but since we are looking for a picture of the earth, we have to look at the other themes. For instance, there are themes here which are for computers, but we can't find a picture of Earth here. For, let's look at environment, and if we scroll up and down, we can see many pictures related to the environment. And you can already see that there is a picture of the Earth here. So left click on it and select that. Now right click. And from the insert options, click on copy. So our picture comes in our slide. Now we can go ahead and close the gallery by taking our pointer back to tools and then clicking on the gallery option once again. The gallery will close. Now our picture is in the slide and selected. So if we drag this picture, we can take it to a position where we want it to be. Also, with use of the green buttons, we can click and keep the pointer pressed, keep our mouse or button pressed on the touchpad, and then we can move it and resize it as we want. Now we want to write some lines about this image. So we know that we need to use the text tool. So we click on the text tool and then click on the slide and drag a box in the slide where we can type in some text. Now you can type any text of your choice, but it should be related to the picture. So here we are typing about the environment itself. You can see we are typing the environment is where we all meet. So that's one sentence. You can similarly, whenever you take a picture, type sentences which are related to that picture. So the first sentence we have typed is the environment is where we all meet. The next sentence we are typing, you can see in the video, where all have a mutual interest. Okay, so like this you can type the lines about the picture, and then if you want you can format these lines, format the text. We are typing another line, it is the one thing all all of us share. Okay. So now if we want to make it bold, we will select this line and we can click on the B option in the formatting toolbar. And we, by selecting the text box, we can move it also as is being shown. So we have selected this, we have gone to B option, clicked on it, it becomes bold. Then if we want the font size, we can select a font size of our liking and click on it. In the next slide, make the picture given to you. If in doubt, take the help of the video. Let us now see how we can insert a new slide and then using the drawing toolbar, create a new picture. You know how to insert a new slide by going to the slide pane, clicking on new slide. Now, since you want to change the slide design, let's click on the slide in the slide pane and do right click. Select the slide design from there. You can see many options are available. My template, presentation background, presentations. So we can take presentation background and click on OK. Again, we choose this particular slide design, which is orange and blue, and then click on OK. So this design gets applied on our slide. So the slide design has changed. Now we want to make a drawing here with the help of the drawing toolbar. So we take a pointer to the drawing toolbar and select one of the options here. Since we wanted to make an octagonal option, we will select the octagonal drawing toolbar and then drag this on the slide. So we will get an octagonal shape here. We can click on this image and then move it, drag it to place it where we want it. Now we can use the line and the filling toolbar to make changes on it. We can change the outline. As you can see in the video, there are many different outlines. You can change that. You can change the width of the outline by increasing it with the upper arrow or decreasing it. It's up to you. And then also the outline color you can change by clicking on this down arrow button and then selecting the color that you like. So this way you can select one of the colors. Now to fill inside, we have options of none, color, gradient, hatching, bitmap. Let's select bitmap. Then in the next down arrow button, when we click there, we will see many bitmap options. As you can see in the video, we can select one which we like. So let's select the metal design and it gets applied in our drawing. In the next slide, make the picture given to you. If in doubt, take the help of the video. With the help of this video, we will once again insert a new slide, change its background, and then insert a cuboid picture, a cubes picture. So take your pointer to the slide pane. Right click and click on new slide. So you get a new slide. Now if you want to change the background, you need to take your pointer to the format option in the menu bar. Click on the page option. And here you see, you need to select the background because we want to change the background. And then if you click on color, there are many options available. None, color, gradient, hatching or bitmap. So you can select the one which you like and then select the color of your choice. So for instance, we have selected color and then by scrolling up and down, we can see different colors and we select, let's say the magenta color. And when we click on OK, you will see a box comes which says, do you want to change for all pages? Since we only want to change in this slide, we will click on no. And it will only change the background for this slide. So when we click on no, you will see that the color of this slide has changed to magenta. Now we want to draw. So we go to the drawing toolbar, click there, and from this we have to now select the cube option. So we select that, left click with your pointer, with your mouse or touchpad, and then drag it. Now with the line and filling toolbar, you can change the boundary line. You can increase the width of the boundary line as is being shown in the video. You can change the color of the boundary line by clicking on this drop down box button and clicking on the color that you like. You can change the color, like we are picking this color, the red 7. Then if you want to change the color inside of your image, click here and you will see none, color, gradient, hatching, bitmap. You can select the one which you like. For instance, we are selecting gradient, and then when we go and click on the next drop down button, you can see different colors and you select the one which you like. Now use the duplicate option to create a duplicate and say what happens with this. If in doubt, take the help of the video. With the help of this video, we will now practice creating duplicate images from an image. So if you want to create duplicates from here, select that, go to the edit menu, and then click on the duplicate option. A box opens, and the first option is for the number of copies. How many copies do you want? So you can click on the up arrow or the down arrow, change the number of copies. Since we want 4 copies, so we select 4, and then down below you can see start from which color and end at which color. So we can click on this drop down button and select the color from which we want to start. Like here we are selecting blue color, and then again from the drop down button of the end color we select another color. So it can be any color of your choice, not necessarily the color that we are selecting in the video. So we have selected orange to end with, and then we click on OK. So once we click on OK, you will see that you get 4 copies of this image on your slide. You can see the 4 copies there. You can click on this image and keep the button on your mouse or touchpad pressed, and then you can drag it to one side. Again, you can click on the second image, drag that to another side. Similarly, drag the third copy and the fourth copy. Now, with the help of header and footer, show how you will insert date, computer shiksha, and slide number at the bottom of the slide. If you face a problem doing this, you can do this with the help of the video. Let us now insert the date, slide number, and computer shiksha with the help of header and footer option. So to do that, we have 4 slides. Let's first select the first slide. After doing this, we will take our pointer to the menu bar and click on view. Once we are there, click on view and click on the header and footer option. Since we want to apply on the slide, we select the slide option here. And since date and time has not been selected, we first select or click on date and time. Now, if you see, it can be fixed or variable. If you want to change the variable in different language, for instance, you can click on this drop down button and select the one which you like. Let's keep it as English USA. Now, if you want to create a footer, let's click on the footer, and then you can type in this footer text box the text that you want. So we are typing computer shiksha, which is the footer that we want. Next, we also want the slide number. So as soon as you tick on the slide number option, you will see that the last place for the slide number is there. The first is for date and time, second is for the footer title, third is for the slide number. And since we want it on all slides, so we will remove this tick mark of do not show on the first slide. We want it on all slides. So then we say apply to all. We click on this option. So you can see your date and time, date has come, and your computer shiksha and the slide number has come. If you want to see it on the big screen, you can take your pointer to slideshow and click on slideshow. And you can see clearly that the date, the computer shiksha, title and slide number 1 has come. If you use the down arrow, you can see the other slides also. So let's click on the down arrow to see the next slide. Once we click that, you will see that the slide number 2 is written here. Click on down arrow and see the third slide and the fourth slide. To come out of this, you need to click on the escape button, ESC, which is on the top left corner of your keyboard. Now, show how you will apply custom animation on all these texts or drawings. If you have a doubt, see the video to do this. With the help of this video, we will now practice applying the custom animation on our text or images or slides. So first we have these 4 slides in this video and we need to apply custom animation. So we take our pointer to the slideshow option and click on the custom animation option. On the right side of the slide, you can see the custom animation options have become available to us. However, they are not highlighted right now. So as soon as we click on the slide that we are choosing and select the text where we want to apply the custom animation, you will see that the option of add in custom animation gets highlighted. So now bring your pointer here and click on it. So you see number of custom animation options are available in emphasis or in exit, motion paths, miscellaneous effects. So if we want to choose one from the entrance, we can scroll up and down. This is how the text would be shown entering the slide. So that's the animation that we are trying to apply. You can click on these and you will see them being applied as a preview on your slide, like diamond, dissolve in. So we select one, flash once for instance, and then we click on OK. So this animation gets applied on the text of your first slide. And you can see it in the preview window also. Select the next slide. Select the image here. Click on add. Again, you have these options available. So let's look at emphasis. We can select color blend or the next one. Or we are just trying the one which we like, we will apply. Diagonal squares from the exit options, dissolve, then flash once, or fly out, peek out, plus, any of these that you like, random bars, spin. So this you can see how the animation would appear on your screen. Let's go back to entrance and look at apply fly in for instance and press on OK. So that animation has got applied on this slide. On the third slide, we've clicked the third slide, click on the image, then bring your pointer to add, left click on that and again scroll up and down. You have so many options here. You can try these out. For instance, descend. So it's descending downwards, click on OK and this animation gets applied. Coming to the fourth slide, we have 5 different images here. So we can select image by image and click on add and keep applying the custom animation that we want. So we have chosen random bars here or wedge and then we click on OK. So the wedge gets applied to the image that we had selected. Next, we have selected the central image and we are applying random effects on it. Press on OK so that this animation gets affected on that image. We have selected the third image and we have selected animation wheel. Press on OK so that animation is applied on it. Fourth image, we are using one of these here, fade in, and we press on OK. So this animation gets applied on this image. And the final image, fifth image, we choose again from the entrance, we are choosing spin in and we click on OK. So this animation gets applied. Now if you want to see how these animations appear in the slideshow, we want to begin from the first slide. So select the first slide, then take your pointer to slideshow, click on slideshow, and then use the down arrow to go from one slide to the next. And you can see the custom animation that you had applied on each of these slides is being shown to you in a slideshow. You can see these five images in the fourth slide coming up. So this is how you will apply custom animation to your slide presentation. Next, create a hyperlink and then show how you will open the same. If you have a doubt, watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, we are going to practice inserting a hyperlink for our file into our Impress file. So first we need to select the file slide in which we want to insert the hyperlink. So we have selected the third slide. Now take the pointer to insert menu of the menu bar and click on hyperlink option. As soon as you click on the hyperlink option, a box opens and it gives you the various options of location where you want to take the file from. Click on the open file icon and there are so many files here. Also, you have the address location. So you can click on the address where your file is that you want to link as a hyperlink. So let's click on desktop and see the files appearing in desktop. We can scroll up and down and let's click on the Impress file here. So when we click on the Impress file, and we click on open, as is being shown in the video to you, you will notice that the link to that, the path for the link of this file appears here. When we click on apply, this path has not been taken. So we need to once again press on the file, open file icon and go to desktop. And we are once again clicking on the Impress file, click on OK. The path has come now. Click on apply and then click on close. So your file hyperlink has been inserted on the slide. Drag it to where you want it. Now if you want to open it, keep the pointer on the file name and when keep the left hand on the control button and then left click. The file will open and you can see the hyperlink file has opened. So this way you can use the hyperlink. Right now we don't need it, so we can just close this file, come back to our original file. Now convert your file into PDF format. If you face a problem in converting to PDF format, then watch the video and do the conversion with its help. With the help of this video, we will now practice how we can convert our file into PDF format. So, to convert our file which has four slides, we just take our pointer to the file menu in the menu bar and then click on export as PDF option. As soon as you click there, you will see a box opens. Now in this box, there are many options. You do not have to make any changes. Only bring your pointer to the export button, which is at the bottom of this box, and click there. So as soon as you bring your pointer and click on the export option, a box opens which will give you the possibility of changing the location where you want to save your PDF file. So you see in this address bar there are many locations possible, or if you you can see the location from here also. So since we want to save it in desktop, let's click on desktop, then come to the file name bar, and here if something is written already, you can just click on that and do a backspace to clear it, and then type the name that you want. So we are going to type Computer Shiksha. Let's type Computer Shiksha 1 as is being shown in the video, and then we click on the save option. So as soon as we take a pointer there and click on that, this file gets saved as a PDF file. If you want to see where your file has been saved, first minimize the impress file from here, and then you can come to the desktop and you can look for your file. Because it's a PDF file, you'll see a PDF icon, Computer Shiksha 1 is written here. If you want to open it, double click on it, and as soon as you double click on it, your PDF file opens and you can see your slides here. You can scroll up and down to see all the four slides that you had in your impress file are also there in the PDF file. So you can see that. Also, you have a zoom option, a zoom button here on top here. So if you click on this and if you click on a different size, you can zoom up or down and you can see all the slides in this PDF file. So since you don't want to use this right now, close it and open your impress file back again. We will end today's class here. Save your file properly and shut down the computer. In today's class, you revised the various options of impress. In the next class, you will all appear for a practical test. So all of you must remain present for the practical test. After that, Computer Shiksha will conduct a written test for all of you. Thank you.